Welcome back to The Morning Blend. Diabetes and heart disease, they're two of the most common and prevalent diseases affecting Americans today. But there are steps you can take right now to live a healthier lifestyle.
Here with advice and tips on preventative care is primary care physician Dr. Justin Maxwell with Healthcare Partners Nevada. Good morning to you. Welcome
back.
Good morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
You treat a lot of people with heart problems and a lot of diabetes issues that a lot of people go through. But what do we need to keep in mind when it comes to taking care of our heart?
First, I think we need to understand how serious heart disease is. It is the leading cause of death in the United States, not only amongst men, but also women. Mm-hmm. And to put it into perspective, it's actually more deadly than all cancers combined.
Wow.
Yes.
My goodness. So then, what are some of the things we should keep in mind as of how heart disease actually affects the body? What's happening with heart disease that causes your body to shut down?
Typically, we think of heart disease as a narrowing of the arteries, yeah, or clotting of the arteries, and then that piece of clot can break off and cut off blood supply to the heart, also known as a myocardial infarction. That's the medical terminology for that. And when that happens, if people survive that, they can have other complications or morbidity, and that could lead to congestive heart failure. So the pumping action of the heart no longer functions as it should. That can lead to a lot of problems, the normal rhythm of the heart. People can go out of rhythm and suffer deadly cardiac arrhythmias from that. But we also need to understand that if you're having plaque buildup in your heart, it's most likely going to be all over the body.
Mm-hmm. What are some things we can do right now in terms of preventative care so we don't have to go to the doctor or face a heart attack?
Well, you do need to go to the doctor.
Yes. Go to the emergency
room. Yes, exactly. That's true, but, you know, to prevent these issues,
sure,
from compounding.
I think the first thing you need to do is get in early to the doctor because you want a really good family history or genetic screening. If you have a family history of diabetes or heart disease, you want to get in because that will change how aggressive we screen you. Mm-hmm. And in addition to that, you want to make sure you are following a healthy lifestyle, appropriate diet, appropriate exercise, making sure you are getting adequate sleep to keep your stress hormones down, mm-hmm, keep your stress level down, whether it's through meditation or other type of activity, and smoking. You have to stop smoking. One of the worst things that you can do to your body is actually smoke, because that furthers the atherosclerotic progression or inflammatory response to those blood vessels.
Luckily, the number of smokers has gone down over the years,
yes,
but still not 0%. 0% would be best. Diabetes is another one of these things, and not always, but very often preventable. What should people keep in mind? How do you treat diabetes?
Well, I think first we need to talk about the different types. There's type 1 and type 2. Mm-hmm. Type 1 diabetes patients, the pancreas no longer secretes insulin, so they need to supplement with insulin. Mm-hmm. Type 2 diabetes, they're still producing insulin, but there's a communication process or problem that is going on between the hormone insulin and the sugar and the receptor of the cell. So we have medications out there to further help with that communication process.
Do we know how many people have diabetes?
I would say roughly about 10% of people living in the United States suffer from diabetes.
No
and it's actually one of the worst chronic medical illnesses that you can have. It literally destroys everything in your body, from your internal organs, from your blood vessels, from your nervous system, and in advanced stages, it can lead to limb amputations or kidney dialysis, and a lot of nerve issues, nerve problems, mm-hmm, blindness.
I know, same with heart disease, with diabetes, at least for type 2, diet and exercise are very important to not get diabetes.
Absolutely, and I think people who do suffer from diabetes or heart disease need to be doing the appropriate or the correct form of diet and exercise. We throw that term around a lot, but what does that really mean? Mm-hmm. So people who are diabetic, you want to follow a low-carbohydrate diet, a diet out there, the paleo diet, does just that. So you're avoiding breads, rice, pastas, sugars, potatoes, a lot of those complex starches that can make that disease process worse. And in addition to that, the type of exercise. So people should be doing high interval training or high intensity cardiovascular exercise. So instead of the 45 minute to hour that you're doing on a treadmill or elliptical and not seeing results, You can do this in about 10 to 15 minutes, and studies have shown that you will actually slim down your waist. Your body fat percentage will actually go down. So it's a better form of exercise. So if you do suffer from diabetes, get in with a physical trainer, start talking about these things.
And once you're diagnosed with diabetes, can you ever get rid of it, or something that you live with and manage for the rest of your life?
That's a good question. That depends.
It depends on who you ask.
It depends, because there is a genetic predisposition. And so some people, it's going to affect more than others. But yes, you can reverse it to a degree, and in some people, if they follow an appropriate diet, specifically weight loss, if they lose the weight, if they lose the abdominal obesity, they can reverse the diabetes. But some people, I mean, we even see type 2 diabetes in really thin individuals. Mm-hmm. So.
That's very interesting. I know Healthcare Partners, you're known for a total care model. Yes. If you go into any Healthcare Partners, you'll hear us talking about this total care model. For those who don't know, explain what a total care model is.
Total care model, first of all, it's the only one of its kind in Las Vegas, and it's a team of medical professionals. We work very hard to provide high-quality healthcare here in Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. I like to think of it as a VIP service of medicine without having to pay the higher cost, but we really educate our patients in terms of what's available to their insurance. Are they getting free gym memberships or meal plans? Educating them about the types of medicines, what medications are free for them if they go through certain pharmacy services and things like that.
And to learn more about your services and the doctors that are on staff, where do we go?
Go to www.hcpnv.com.
I know you have a lot of professionals around the Valley, and yes. There's one near you. It's great having you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Just saw him last week. Yeah. I got some weight to lose. To learn more about Healthcare Partners Nevada, go to the website on your screen. You could also follow them on Facebook and Twitter.